Hey guys, welcome to another workout, and today it's all about the foam roller. Hopefully you got one at home. If you don't, probably a good investment to make and get one of them. Perfect for recovery, for rolling out tight muscles, and also can be used for strength work and stability work. And that's what we're going to be doing today. We're going to be going with 16 minutes non-stop, going at 40 seconds on, 20 seconds off, and just getting a little bit more stability as we kind of develop that strong body for running. All right, first exercise, super simple. Sitting down on the ground, and you're literally going to have, we're going to start with the left side, and I keep that posture up nice upright, and we're literally going to go side back to the other side. If this is too easy, you can move that out a little bit. So then you get a little bit more work in those quads, in that hip flexor, and a little bit more mobility. So a little bit easier the closer it is to you. So we got a little bit less movement. Make it harder, put it further away from your feet. So we're gonna go 40 seconds on one side, 40 seconds on the other side, and then we keep going with a full workout. Put the phone down here. All right. Let's get going. Let's get stronger. All right, let's go. So just nice and controlled, just warming up through it. I mean, for me, straight away, hip flexor is doing a lot of work. I make sure that I stay upright, so I don't let my lower back do much work. Obviously, I'm gonna support myself with my hands. It can get a little bit harder if you don't have your hands on the ground. So 100% up to you. Knowing that this is the first exercise out of 16, and I leave that support on. And last 4 seconds. 3, 2, 1. All right, well done. Same thing on the other side. So side on. This looks like this. Alright, but this time on the right hand side, I'll stay front onto you so you can see this. Alright, 5 seconds, take a deep breath, getting that mobility, hip flexor stronger. Alright, let's go. As I said, if this is too easy, you can move that out a little bit further out. And as you get better at this exercise, you should be moving it out a little bit more. Obviously, don't try and go all the way out there on the first time you've tried this exercise. And take your time building it slowly. So a nice easy touch with your heel every time. So we're not looking for an impact, just a touch and go. Super important for hip flexors as you launch forward when you run. So I'm trying to keep my upper body forward so I'm not twisting with it. All right, well done. All right, second exercise, facing forward. So that foam roller is going to be facing forward. I'm going to have one foot on the ground, one foot off, and literally just going to squat up and down. So really making sure that I'm in line. All right, let's go. So here we're pretty much developing a lot of single leg strength, but then also that hip stability as we got one side is a bit off. So making sure that is a straight line. So you don't want it to be facing that way. And literally about to sit back down. Again, not a super hard exercise, but definitely slowly improving that stability in the hips and building that uneven strength all around the hips. Last 5 seconds. All right, 20 seconds rest. I'm just gonna show you side on what it looks like. So I keep straight lines with both feet. So both feet are in line, and I literally sit back, get back. All right, so we're gonna be going to the other side. We've got 5 seconds. Set yourself up, set up straight lines, toes in line, let's go. Feet just about shoulder width apart, nice and controlled through it. 30 seconds left. Doing well. Just mixing things up. You don't want to get used to the same exercises You do too much of the same exercise, your body gets used to it and doesn't get surprised anymore, and that improvement rate is a lot slower. So we're mixing up a lot of different exercises. Last 2 seconds. All right, well done. All right, good. Next one, lying down on the ground. You're gonna have both feet on it. And we're literally just gonna take a few steps forward, a few steps back. All right. All right, let's go. Hips off the ground. And we're gonna walk it forward just a little bit. And then walk it slowly back. So getting those hamstrings a good workout. So very, very controlled here. I'm gonna be doing 2 sets of this. Well, 4 sets all up, but 2 sets in a row. It's all about that control. Not trying to go too fast. Building that hip strength by lifting our hips off the ground. Good strength. And also a lot of hamstring work here. Alright, good. Give yourself 20 second rest. We're gonna do it again. So my main focus here is not to go too fast. I'm in control. And not go, you don't have to go too far in or too far out. You don't have to try and reach your max. Stay in that range that it feels comfortable. Straighten that up. Alright, let's go. Stay in that range where it feels comfortable. Just slowly looking to improve. Those sessions are not meant to kind of bring you down to the point where you feel it for the next 3 or 4 days. Because hopefully you're still running at the same time. So we're looking at those strength sessions as side dishes to your main course. Your main course is your running, and the strength work is just a side dish. Glues everything together, makes that meal taste good. Alright, well done. Alright, next one, nice and easy. We're gonna go into a downward dead bug. So this position right here, I'm gonna have one hand on the foam roller and literally just go in touch to my shoulder. I'll stay front on so you can see. Alright, so starting with the right side of the foam roller, so left touches the opposite shoulder, building that stability in the core. So it just adds that little element of stability, which makes it just a little bit harder than doing it without. Just like that fact that the core has to work a little bit harder here. Last 10 seconds. So nice, easy touch, very controlled with the core. Keep the core strong. All right, well done. So again, side on, it's gonna look like this. All right, I'll stay front on for this one. Going other hand, so if you weren't with me, we're going with the left side this time. All right, knees off the ground, straight lines, touch. Touch, touch, touch. Nice and controlled through it. See if you can have a straight line with where your arms finish, where your hands finish with every set. Halfway there, facing down. Last 12 seconds. Almost there. Definitely feeling that one. Alright, well done. Alright, we're gonna go back to the first set. So we're halfway there. 8 exercises done, 8 to go. So the same as what we did in the first one. Just gonna get that nice easy movement out on each side. Alright, let's go. So very controlled here, even though we are doing it on time, we're looking for control. All right, if this gets too easy, bring that out a little bit more. You really start feeling it a bit. If your hands are not on the ground, the core just gets involved a little bit more. Might as well get a little bit more out of this exercise with 10 seconds to go. Just try and stay upright. Don't let your back roll. It gets a bit harder now. All right, well done. 20 seconds rest, we're gonna go other side. So just try when you do that, not to get to the point where that back really rolls. Just try and keep it nice and straight. All right, so find that spot where it feels comfortable, where you feel like you're getting a bit of work, but you're not overdoing it. Bam, on my right foot this time. All right, let's go. Nice and controlled. Doing well. 25 seconds left. It's nice and easy with it. It's about consistency. Doing this exercise once is good. Doing it twice is great. Doing this exercise once a week for the next 3 or 4 weeks will really benefit your running, your strength, your ability to run strong and stay injury free. All right, well done. To come up to the basic squats. So just as before, side on, I'll show you side on. So I'll find that balance, feet just around shoulder width apart. And going down, whoa, starting to sweat a bit, literally going down. All right, let's go. A bit late. Started just a tiny bit late. Today's another warm day in Australia, 37 degrees. 11th of April. Hopefully the last warm day this year. Running will become a lot easier in winter. I know many of you are not running right now, so this is a perfect time to work on your weaknesses, develop that base, develop that strength. All right, let's go other side. So again, I'm looking for that evenness. So first of all, put that foot down, then I make sure they're both in line. So we don't want to step forward on one and step back on the other. We want to create those straight lines just about shoulder width apart. All right, let's go. Nice and controlled. Imagine you're sitting back. Again, this exercise is not meant to be super hard. It's not like you're doing squats in the gym with 50 kilograms on. This is about that stability. It's about getting those hips stronger just by adding something unstable as a foam roller. Last 8 seconds. Doing well. Last one. All right, well done. All right, on the ground, getting to those hip bridges together with a walk through them. And just get the center of the shot. All right, so literally very, very controlled. Small steps out, small steps back, hips off the ground the whole time. All right, let's do it. Lift up, small steps out. So that's an exercise I've been doing for years to get my hamstrings stronger, my glutes stronger. Doesn't have to be too far out of the comfort zone. It's just a few steps forward, few steps back. Same as running. You don't get better in running by putting one great workout where you go all out. It's about that consistency of doing a workout at 90%, but doing it 10 times in a row after 10 weeks. You will really see the improvements. All right, down. Let me just straighten that up. All right, 15 seconds to go. Catch your breath. Make sure your hips are off the ground the whole time. That way the glutes are doing a bit of work as well. All right, let's do it. Up and slowly moving forward. Nice and controlled. The further you go away from your body, the more the carbs are doing work as well. So definitely getting a lot of muscles here with one exercise. I should be doing this exercise barefooted just to have a bit more control. It's a little bit harder with shoes. Alright, well done. Come up nice and easy. Just gonna go into the core, last one. Nice and sweaty already. Alright, so we're in this position right here and just touch, touch, touch. Alright, deep breath, knees off the ground, let's go. It's really building a strong core. This exercise is not gonna get you a six pack, but it's gonna build stability in your core. So when you run, you can really keep a good strong form for longer. Keep a stronger pace for longer. Almost there. Whew. Starting to feel it now. Last 10 seconds. 5, 3, last one. Well done. Good, give yourselves 20 seconds. And the same thing on the other side. So again, slide on. I'm in this position right here. Alright, so I'm going to be on my left side. Alright, last exercise. Alright, knees off the ground. Touch, touch, touch. Nice and controlled. 16 minute workout almost done. Doesn't have to be too long. Just has to be consistent. You don't have to do 2 hour gym sessions. You'll get a lot more out of doing 16 minute workouts a week than doing two hour workouts a week. Do long workouts, your body will be tired, your next run will be affected, and you're gonna get the most out of that run. So you're slowing your improvements down. All right, well done. Good. Sweating a little bit. So as I was saying in the last exercise, you will get a lot more out of your strength work if you do a 16 minute workout 7 days a week rather than try and do 2 really long workouts twice a week or 3 times a week. That consistency is super important, but also making sure you don't overdo it. I see a lot of people go to the gym, lift super heavy weights, then try and do a key workout, try and do your tempo, your speed, your heel repeats, and your legs are heavy. You know, you're a bit tight, you don't get that mobility in, and that's actually slowing down your work, your running, your improvement in running. So this is not about becoming a bodybuilder. That's not an exercise that's gonna make you a bodybuilder. That's not a workout that's gonna make you a bodybuilder. This is the kind of exercises, workouts that you wanna be doing together with your running to become a better runner. All right, if you have any other questions, any comments, leave them below. Otherwise, subscribe to the channel. Smash that like button and I'll see you in the next video. Peace.